This is the day they arrived.
The object touched down.
We've been wondering whether we are alone in the universe since the dawn of civilization.
There's a whole fleet of them. Look on the ASA.
But it's only in recent years that this question has gotten much, much more interesting. Specifically, with the release of UAP footage by the Pentagon, UFO enthusiasts around the world got very excited about the idea of aliens visiting us. But there are many people who remain skeptical about the content of the video footage provided by the US Department of Defense that they are indeed out of this world. Among the skeptics is astrophysicist Neil deGrasse Tyson.
I mean, I'm very matter-of-fact about this, and the whole UFO community, as best as I can sense, they're just angry with me that I'm not just all in on mysterious things being visiting aliens. I'm content with them just being mysterious, really. You know, the universe brims with mysteries. The question is, what's your first thought? And the idea that you encounter something you don't understand, and your first thought is, it's aliens. Well, maybe it's not your first thought is, oh, you lightly discount other things it might be and go straight to the alien hypothesis. And that's what you want. Okay. I don't have a problem with that. I just find it so unconvincing is that I'm not going to devote my professional life to investigating it, but other people are. And I think that's great. Lights in the sky, we can't explain. I would hope some fraction of our $700 billion federal defense budget goes to figuring out what these things are on the possibility they could be a threat. I have no problems with that.
Among the most popular UFO encounter stories on the internet is the 2004 USS Nimitz UFO incident off the coast of San Diego, California, where several pilots from VFA 41 Squadron flying Super Hornets from the USS Nimitz were directed by the USS Princeton to intercept one of several unidentified flying objects detected by radar. The pilots reported a visual encounter and recorded an infrared video. The Navy has verified that the video was taken by Navy personnel and stated that it has not yet identified the nature of the sightings, which they classify as unexplained aerial phenomena. Fighter pilot Commander David Favor of the USS Nimitz Carrier Strike Group claims to have investigated radar indications of a possible target off the coast of Southern California. Favor was told that the USS Princeton had been tracking unusual aircraft for 2 weeks prior to the incident. An unusual aircraft would appear at 80,000 feet before descending rapidly towards the sea, only to stop at 20,000 feet above the sea and then hovering. Commander David Favor reported that he saw a white oval object hovering above the ocean disturbance. This later became known as the Tic Tac UFO. Favor says that he and three other people witnessed the object for about 5 minutes as he spiraled down to get a closer look, but this mysterious craft ascended, mirroring the trajectory of his airplane, until it disappeared. Many people have invoked this incident, as well as many others like it, as evidence of aliens visiting Earth.
I don't feel so obligated to have to say what it is. I'm completely content saying I don't know what it is. But the act of me saying I don't know what it is not equivalent to me saying I know what it is. It's aliens. And it's that bridge that is built by UFO fans that is not built by the skeptic. And I would also say that whatever confidence you have in your electronics, I'd still bet that there are artifacts in your electronics you have not thought about or considered that are more likely to me as an explanation of what you saw than intelligent aliens visiting from another planet. And you're saying it can't be the electronics. Well, how do you know it can't be? That's like saying my computer system is hack-proof. No, it's not. It's only hack-proof to people who are only as smart as you. To someone smarter than you, it's hackable. That's the definition of not being as smart as someone who can pull that off on you. So you can't tell me you know every possible artifact. Every machine I've ever used has had artifacts. And what you do is you characterize them in such a way so that you can remove them from the actual data you were trying to get. And you study what the artifact is later. But if you want to believe your artifact is real, then you're stuck saying this has got to be hypersonic craft from China or aliens visiting. Now, here's my, I don't want to call it a rebuttal, but just, this is just how I think about it. I say to myself, 6 billion high resolution color photographs and videos are uploaded to the internet every day. 6 billion. 3 billion smartphones are in use around the world today. the citizens of the world are unwittingly crowdsourced as observers of anything that could be visiting Earth. You could live stream your next encounter with an alien who's walking up to you. In the old days, they say, oh, they zapped my camera and now there's no film. Now, it seems to me, if an alien's walking towards you, you can live stream that. And that will go viral within minutes. Cat videos go viral within minutes. So you know an alien walking towards you is going to go viral. And the accounts of alien abductions have dropped to near zero. So then you have to ask, let's assume they are aliens. Let's give that. Why would they only reveal themselves to Navy pilots? The military does not have eyes on the entire world the way 7 billion people do, okay? So yes, we do monitor. Yes, there are first alert things. Yes, I get that. But you want nice evidence of an alien spacecraft? And the best thing you have for me with your highly sophisticated Navy equipment is a fuzzy monochromatic Tic Tac? If that's your best evidence, you have more work to do.
Given the estimated number of stars in the observable universe, which is about 1 septillion, that is 1 followed by 24 zeros, it almost certainly seems we cannot possibly be alone in the universe. But even if galaxies are teeming with life, that doesn't automatically mean intelligent aliens are traversing interstellar space and visiting Earth. These two separate concepts are most often conflated by people who attack Neil deGrasse Tyson and other UFO skeptics like him, and portray them as anti-alien.
I'd love me some aliens. That would be a discovery of all of civilization. So first of all, notice how frequently aliens are hostile to us as portrayed in movies. We are basing this on actual evidence of how we treat each other, rather than on any notion of how aliens would actually treat us. So in other words, we are projecting onto aliens what we already know we do to each other. So I think our fear of aliens derives not from knowledge of how they would behave, but from knowledge of how we would behave, not with each other, and probably how we would treat other aliens as well. So I think that's what's going on there. That's my first point. Second, nearly all the aliens portrayed, they walk, they talk, they have two arms, legs, head. Look at E.T., look at the aliens in Close Encounters of the Third Kind. Even in the movie series Alien, it didn't specifically have legs, it was vertebrate. A face is a very vertebrate thing to have, all right? If you're not a vertebrate in this world, you don't have much of a face. And traditional face that we think of, it tends to be a vertebrate phenomenon. And so we are then making aliens vertebrates.
It's very exciting to speculate about the form of an alien species, but the reality remains that we only have one sample of life, so we have no clue what an alien would actually look like. Not until the day where we have irrefutable evidence of extraterrestrial life. But let's say for a moment that that day has already arrived and aliens are indeed visiting us. Should we be fearful of them? Will the fact of knowing we are not alone in the universe affect how we treat one another? Should we expect aliens to be interested in human affairs?
By the way, the hubris of us to imagine that aliens would care about us or be curious about us, that's hubris. It's like, we're so interesting that another species that can travel across the galaxy is going to study our behavior. So just to believe that we are so interesting that something as advanced as a civilization with flying saucers to cross the galaxy would sit there and want to analyze us. So that's hubris. But also, the human being trying to make sense of their world. And when things don't make sense, we have the urge to make it make sense so that we can think about it in some way that's consistent with our life experience. I've had people say, oh, I saw this bright light in the sky. It was huge. You know, so even our capacity to retell things is compromised because we're human. So all I'm asking for is among the 6 billion images and videos uplifted to the internet every day that are high resolution, it'd be nice if a few of them had an alien getting out of their spacecraft.
Ask yourself, do you want it to be true that we've been visited by aliens? If the answer is yes, then there is even more reason for you to remain skeptical. Think about it. The thing that you want to be true is also the thing you already believe in. We may one day see better footage that would definitely constitute evidence for alien life and it wouldn't take much to convince even the most strident skeptic. But until then, we still don't know the answer to the question, are we alone in the universe? Thanks for watching. Did you like this video? Then show your support by subscribing and ringing the bell to never miss videos like this.